We'll now make a strange and counterintuitive step. You know that human chromosomes are linear, but we want to think about them as circular, cyclic chromosomes. Why would we do this? Why would we distort the biological reality? The only reason is that it will make our algorithmic problem much simpler while actually hardly affecting our biological conclusion. Remember, I told you that analyzing rearrangements in linear chromosomes is extremely difficult, even if we deal with a unichromosomal genome. Analyzing rearrangements in multichromosomal linear genomes becomes nearly impossible. And surprisingly enough, analyzing rearrangements in multichromosomal genomes with these cyclic chromosomes will turn out quite simple. We are about to discover it. So now we will look at the cyclic genomes, in this case cyclic genome, a genome with a circular chromosome consisting of two chromosomes, and we will arrange blocks in these chromosomes as directed black edges. For example, plus A minus B minus D plus C will be arranged as four edges with this corresponding orientation of these edges along the circle. It's just the start. We will now add to these black edges undirected red edges that connect adjacent syntony blocks. So the two chromosomal genome will be represented as a graph consisting of two cycles. These are cycles important. They have edges of two colors, red and black. Now, what do we do next? First, let's notice that for every genome, there are many different ways to visualize it. For example, this is genome Q arranged in natural order along a cycle. But we can change arrangements of black edges of Q, and how in this case this cycle look like. Well, after plus A, we should go to minus B. That's what we do. After minus B, we should go to minus D. That's what we do. And after minus D, we should go to plus C, and finally to plus A. This is the same genome and the same graph, in fact, the same cycle, just visualized differently. Now, let's try to figure out how a reversal looks like in terms of these graphs. So we start with genome P plus A plus B minus C plus D. And let's make a reversal on this genome, resulting is plus A minus B minus D and plus C. How this new genome Q will look like in terms of our graph model? Well, after plus A, we should go to minus B. After minus B, we should go to minus D. After minus D, we should go to plus C. And finally, from plus C, we should go to plus A. So therefore, transformation of genome P into genome Q corresponds also to transformations of the graph shown here. And how can we summarize what this transformation does? Certainly, it removes these two red edges. And it adds two new red edges. So in summary, a reversal essentially now has geometric interpretation. It deletes two red edges and replaces them by two other red edges on the same four nodes. Now, let's now talk about fission, breaking a single chromosome into two. In this case, a unichromosomal genome P is broken into a genome with these two chromosomes, genome Q. So how does it look like in terms of our graph? So from plus A, we should go to minus B. And from minus B, we should go to plus A. So it will look like this. And also from minus C, we should go to plus D. And from D, we should go to C. So you see that geometrically also a single cycle is broken into two cycles. What does it mean geometrically again? Once again, we remove two red edges and add two new red edges. And similarly, in the case of fusion reverse operation, we would also remove two red edges and add two new red edges. And therefore, we define the notion of two-break, a rearrangement that replaces two red edges with two new red edges on the same four nodes. What we have just accomplished, instead of four different operations, reversals, translocations, fusions, and fissions, we have a single operation, a two-break. I describe how to model reversals, fusions, and fissions as two-breaks. What about translocations? The same story. Here are two linear chromosomes that, after translocations, transform into a blue chromosome and a green chromosome, shown here. Once again, we represent them as black-red passes. Let's circleize them by just gluing the ends using one of the red edges. And after we circleize them, let's perform a two-break. We'll choose these two edges, we'll remove them, and substitute it by other two red edges. And afterwards, we will simply remove the edges that we use for circularization, like here, which is essentially linearization of circular chromosomes. So if you look at this, then you see that we essentially mimic translocations using our graphs. And we will define two-break distance as the minimum number of two breaks transforming one genome into another. And two-break distance problem, input two genomes on the same set of synteny blocks, and output the two-break distance between these genomes. It's now time to solve this problem, but before we do this, we need to introduce the key notion in studies of genome rearrangements, which is called the breakpoint graphs.